Here in Northern Ireland, we have 40% of people who are not going out to vote. Why are they not going out to vote? Because I think a lot of them reject tribal politics. They want something different, and yet, who is going to represent them, or where is the voice?
So I do a lot of work with the Social Enterprise Hub in my area, in Downpatrick. And they just got notice yesterday by a very brief and blunt email that they had to vacate their premises by mid-March, that they had to be out the door with no transitional arrangements, no post-funding support whatsoever. The DFC, Department for Communities, has simply given them notice that they have to be out, and that is a clear result of the lack of a budget, the lack of any sort of organisation at the top level of government in this province.
I decided to join the Alliance Party after getting some first-hand experience on the front line of American politics this summer with Senator John McCain in Washington DC, and I came home and found myself shouting a lot more at the TV than usual, and found myself being a bit of a hypocrite and criticising people instead of taking change and showing leadership.
There were a lot of people who were growing up, you know, as teenagers, being told if you want to make a life for yourself it has to be outside of this country. And I will say the majority of my school friends don't live in Northern Ireland anymore. I left as well. And what I said to myself was, if I was ever to come back to Northern Ireland, one of the main things that I would want to do would be to join the Alliance Party and start to be active in it, because it was the only party that I saw my values reflected in.
I think I probably have to reiterate what everyone else has said. Fed up, had enough, just think we deserve better than what we're getting. We're not getting it.
I'm a member of the Alliance Party because they're the only group of people in Northern Ireland who seem to think the same way as I do, that actually can work together and say, look, put the border to one side for a second, there is a constitutional referendum we can have if we want, but let's just get on with working together and actually work together. Don't just talk about it, actually work together.
All along, our party, right from the early days, is actually trying to say that openness, transparency is what governing should be about. If we govern in an open and transparent way, if we let people see how and why we make decisions, then they will have faith in us and they will vote for us again and again. And that's why I put myself forward for this election, because I want to make sure that North Belfast will finally have a voice that will work for everyone.
Whenever I went out about the constituency on Saturday, Sunday of the weekend, they spoke about the fact that they've been let down. And that is what is so important in this election. We need to be a voice for everybody. Listening to people in that area speaking about how their young people were being taken by suicide, were being left without any prospects. And we've got to develop a strong, credible voice so people can put themselves on the line and can say, Alliance is the party for me.
I joined the party originally as a 17-year-old because of the unwillingness of Sinn Féin and the DUP to face up to the need for a fair and decent integrated education settlement in Oman. The anger that I've really started to feel with the RHI scandal and the cost of division, it angers me that this kind of money on this scale is being wasted when I think about the fact that there are parts of Strabane where half of the kids are growing up in poverty. Whenever I think about that, I go on my Facebook every week and I see a number of person that I grew up with is leaving to go to Australia or Canada or to Britain because they don't see a life for themselves here. So I think that there is a real need for progressive, liberal, inclusive alternative in communities like West Tyrone, Fermanagh, South Tyrone and the Mid-Ulster, where quite frankly the established tribal politics hasn't delivered for people in the way that it was promised. I think that we have something positive to offer. I think that if people give us the chance, we can genuinely change politics and life for people in Northern Ireland for the better. And I hope that that is what happens on March 2nd.